When I was invited to the Côte d'Azur to bring my instrument, that is, the 14 cats in my band, would you believe that after traveling through Africa, the Far East, the Near East, Japan, North America, and Europe, this was my first time in the French Riviera. Now, of course, the French Riviera to some people means gambling at Monte Carlo, the bikinis at Cannes, and the in crowd at Saint-Tropez. Well, of course, I have nothing against gambling, particularly if you win. And I wouldn't dare say that there was anything unwonderful about a luxuriously appointed bikini. And there's nothing like being with it, with the inn people. But to me, it was a chance to see some of the fine art that France has to offer. An opportunity to visit the most beautiful museum in the world, the Meg Foundation at Saint Paul de Vence. There we saw Calder Mobiles and the incredible Giacometti sculpture. And in person, the celebrated Spanish artist, Joan Miró. Can you imagine me having the great Miró as my personal guide to his works? And then a piano moves into the picture. And while the trio is trying to swing like crazy, Miró, the jazz fan, sort of cools by one of his elaborate pieces of sculpture. And then you'll see ceramics by Leger at Biot and the famous Picasso sculpture at Valoris. And then we take you backstage for a close-up view of our rehearsal, where you'll see the cats in the band very nonchalantly sitting around on their double flat sort of waiting to be impressed by some quadruple sharps. You'll see us take things out of the music, one bar here, put another bar in there. And as I say, sometimes they play pretty good. Then you see the same number in the actual performance before the public at the Antibes Jazz Festival. The first face you see will be that of my very favorite composer, the writer of Something to Live For, A-Train, Lush Life, and so many of the things I love. My writing and arranging companion, Billy Strayhorn. And now the festival builds to a tremendous climax. And to cap the climax, we call on the beyond category First Lady of Song, Ella Fitzgerald. We took our music to the south of France, and we brought away an inspiration that was as big and beautiful as the Mediterranean itself.
Several years ago, Billy Strayhorn and I did a Shakespearean suite, which is called Such Sweet Thunder. We'd like now to do the title number for you. This is taken from Othello. It was said that Othello gave Desdemona such a sweet and swinging line of talk, and she went for it, and of course he married her. Her father objected and tried to have the marriage annulled. And when they took the case to court, why, the Duke of Venice said that he was certain that had Othello said the same thing to his daughter, she would have gone for it too, because it was such sweet thunder. We'll be right back.
through three of our vintage oldies, the Black and Tan Fantasy, Creole Love Call, and the Mooch.
Thank you.
This is the Picasso man holding a young kid that he gave to the small village of Valerice. This village, by the way, owes its very existence to Picasso, who made it the ceramic capital of France. This tremendous mosaic is the front of the Leger Museum at Biot. And the enormous ceramic fills up one end of the landscape in front of the museum. Alexander Calder is, I believe, the only major American artist at the Meg Foundation. He certainly is the best and most famous artist working the medium of the mobile. This mobile is at the entrance to the museum. Those tall, slender figures that surrounded me when I played, the men walking and the women standing, are, as you may have recognized, the essence of Giacometti.
Voyez l'oiseau avec un oiseau au sommet, ce graphisme là avec une étoile.
Yeah, it's beautiful.
Yeah?
It's wonderful.
The three major mural sculptures that you see are first outlined against this landscape, the fork. Then Miro and I walk through the arch, arriving finally at the egg.
As I said at the outset, you would see a rehearsal at which the band and I work out a number, adding, subtracting, experimenting, until finally it is resolved in its public appearance. Actually, I began my composing long before the band rehearsal, when at Meg's, while playing with the trio, I was struck by an idea which finally emerged as part of the regular concert program.
Top. Johnny Hodges. Johnny Hodges.
Last January, we premiered a new work of ours on our concert tour in anticipation of our visit to Dakar, Senegal, Africa, the first international Negro art festival. The title of this number is La Plus Belle Africaine.
Thank you.
Jimmy Hamilton, clarinet. Harry Connie, baritone sax. John Lamb, bass. Sam Woodyard, drum.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, Her Majesty, the Queen, Ella.
Cigarette holder, which wigs me over my Right about here, we'd like to change the pace and sing something pretty from our Duke Ellington album, one we hope you like. It's called I Want Something to Live For. I have almost everything a human could desire. Cars and houses, bearskin rugs to place before my fire. But there's something missing. Something isn't there. It seems I'm never kissing the one who adventurous dream. Oh, what wouldn't I give for someone to take my life and make it seem gay, as they say it ought to be. Why can't I have love like that brought to me?
So dance the samba. Bye, 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 bye. vai. So dance a samba, so dance a samba, vai. The jazz samba, how it gets to you. The jazz samba, ooh, you. The jazz samba, thrills you through and through. You get that feeling, you start reeling, ooh. That crazy beat, the way they play their tunes, the Brazilian beat, can't be beat, you'll be humming soon. The jazz samba, how it gets to you. Come on, get with them, let's start that rhythm, ooh.
Everybody,
This is, things ain't what they used to be, and we use it now for the purpose of giving background to this finger-snapping bit, ladies and gentlemen. You are cordially invited to join the finger-snapping. I see I don't have to tell you that one never snaps one's fingers on the beat. It's considered aggressive. Don't push it, just let it fall. Crazy. And if you would like to be conservatively hip, then at the same time, tilt the left earlobe. Establish a state of abandon. And if you would like to be respectably cool, then tilt the left earlobe on the beat and snap the finger on the afterbeat, thus. Then you really don't care. And so by routining one's finger snapping and choreographing one's earlobe tilting, one discovers that one can become as cool as one wishes to be. With that, we want to thank you for the wonderful way you've inspired us and remind you that you are very, very beautiful, very sweet, very gracious, very generous, and we do love you madly. Thank you.